Hello everyone, it's Catherine here from Inky Finger Cat, and I've got another Christmas in July project. So following on from the previous ones, using up those inky backgrounds and one of the die-cut words of peace that I had pulled to one side, and they were still sat on my desk, so I thought, right, let's go with it. So this one I popped into an embossing folder that I got in a magazine kit. I have no idea what magazine kit it was now. But it comes with stamps, dies, and an embossing folder. And I went over the embossing with some white ink, and then I thought I would only have picked up the actual raised parts, but I hadn't. So this was a bit of a disaster. So I ended up then brushing it off as much of the embossing powder as I could, because this was a white, opaque and holographic glittery type of one. And then the last bits that were on, I thought, well, fair enough. If they're still on the background, fair enough. So now I've decided, right, well, let's try and raise some of the embossing out a little bit more by putting some colour on. So I've used eucalyptus ink from Concord & Knife, and I'm still not happy with this. So I then go and grab my white pearl embossing powder, which is not as opaque, so it doesn't matter if it covers up some of the background, because it just tints the background and gives it a pearly sheen, and I'm much happier with how this ends up looking. You still can't see the embossing particularly predominant, but it doesn't matter, because I end up deciding that that's absolutely going to be part of the background, but it's a little bit more intense than it was. I'm still convinced I'm going to use that piece die cut, but I decide that actually from that same kit I'm going to stamp out, I'm going to stamp out the floral image onto white using that same eucalyptus ink, which I stamp it a few times just to darken it up and give it a little bit more depth of colour, and then I'm going to fussy cut it out. And this is going to sit underneath that piece, but offset from where the pattern is on the embossing folder. So the embossing folder becomes part of the background, but it's clearly all linked, because it's all the same pattern, basically. It's the same poinsettia pattern on the embossing folder as it was on the stamped image. So probably should have fast-forwarded this a little bit more, because it's not the most exciting thing to watch, is me fussy cutting. For those who don't like fussy cutting, do you know what? Don't use an image that doesn't have a coordinating die. That's all I'll say. So I decide that I want to stack it up a little bit, and I've just got that little bit of leftover cardstock that I've just cut this image from. So I do four little layers, and it just gives me a little bit of dimension between the background and the flowers, and then just glued them into place and glued that die cut straight on. So I've grabbed the Peace and Joy stamp set, and I'm just going to finish off the sentiment, so it's peace to the world. And oh dear, my Versamark is so filthy. I really need to get a clean new Versamark pad. And this time I'm going to use the opaque white. And this time I'm also going to heat from behind. This is a little tip if you think that you've not got enough Versamark there. Heat from behind, because it'll actually stick itself through the heating process. And it does come out quite nicely, actually, this. Sometimes those stamps don't stamp so well, but this one comes out quite well. And I add that on. Now, I'm now deciding which card blank to use, and I decide to go for one that was pre-made in the cupboard already, and it was perfectly sized for this panel. Usually I've cut my panels a little bit too big, and so I end up going for the bigger card size, but this one, I'd obviously done it perfectly sized. I did use both double-sided tape and a little bit of glue, so I'd got a bit of wriggle room, which is good, because I did need to just slightly adjust. And now I'm just deciding, do I want gems? And I decide I do want gems, and I go for these unicorn ones from Waffle Flower, and just pick out those tealy ones. So they're quite subtle, but they're very pretty, and they go with the pearlescent background. So at this point, I think, oh, come on, inside of the card as well. We need to do something for the inside of the card. Try my hardest, not always, but just stamp the image on the inside. And that's it done. This took literally about 16 minutes to do from start to finish, including a little bit of procrastinating. So, dead easy card. Okay, I hope you enjoyed. Please do give me a thumbs up if you did. Please leave me a comment below. And until next time, Oh, please subscribe if you want to see more. But until next time, goodbye.